Hello friends, good morning and good evening everyone. So today we are going to discuss the remaining portion of this DC motor design. Hello friends, so now we are going to continue the session of our previous one. So previously we just calculated diameter and length we took like 0.170 meter. Similarly diameter we took like 0.4 meter. So this is the main dimensions. Now let us calculate some other parameters. So first calculate the pole pitch. So pole pitch is the pole center to center, that is the pole pitch. We will say like tau. So that is nothing but pi into d by number of poles. You have pi and you have 0.4 is the diameter and you have number of poles 4. So this value will give like pi into 0.4 by 4. So you will get 0.314 meter. So 0.314 meter is the 0.314 meter is the pole pitch for us. So what is the pole arc now? Pole arc is nothing but we will say B. That B is nothing but zeta into tau. Zeta, that is the ratio, generally we will say 67%. So say this is one pole and this is another pole, then this is the pole arc, right? We already discussed. So 67% is occupied by the pole arc, 67% of that length, 0.314. so let's calculate it, 0.7 into 0.314. Now you got 0.210. So 0.210. So it means 210 mm is nothing but the pole arc. So you have some other parameters also, like peripheral velocity of the armature. So let us calculate peripheral velocity. So we will say V of armature, that is nothing but so pi into d into ns. We already know that d is the 0.4 and the ns is the rotations per second, revolution per second, that is 16.67. so let's calculate the entire this value, 0.4 into pi into 0.4 into 16.67. so we got 20.948. Let us take this value as 21 meter per second. So this is the peripheral velocity of armature. So whatever armature is there, so that is rotating with a peripheral speed of 21 meter per second. So we already calculated this L as 170 mm, as this is of a more length. Say for example, this is very bigger length, means cooling is very difficult for whatever the iron part is there, armature length is there, cooling becomes very difficult. So for this much length, at least we should use one cooling duct here. Minimum one cooling duct, one number of 10 mm cooling duct, we should use it on this job, on this armature core length, then the cooling will be more good. So if from the entire length of 170 mm, we have to remove the cooling duct area, cooling duct length, so that you can calculate net iron length. So what is the net iron length now? Net iron length is nothing but that 10 mm we should remove. But this is formed by laminations, so stacking factor you have to consider, the space factor for the core. Generally we will consider 90%. So from that 170 mm, we are going to remove this 10 mm. So 0.9 into 170 minus 10. So that is 160. So we got 144 mm. So this is nothing but 0.144. This is the net iron length. Similarly, the frequency of reversal. So in a D, even though this is the DC motor, the operating inside voltages are of alternating in nature, the frequency of reversal is nothing but we will say f that is nothing but we have to use the power, this formula Pn by 2. So P, we know that it is already 4 into 16.67 is the rotations per second by 2. So we got 33.34. So 33.34, that is the frequency for us. And the lamination thickness for this machine, the lamination thickness we used as 0.35 mm. This is the lamination thickness. So now we just now finished the calculation of dimensions, the major dimensions we just now calculated. So let us go for further analysis, that is armature design, armature winding, slots and all in this next video or next part. Thank you. Thanks for watching. Do watch other parts of this video.